something for the healers today.
What I would not give to trade with the Zeswa again.
Ah, there you are!
Only you talk.
Priya, I'm approaching the fissure just to the north of you. What should I do?
Right. There's an RDA clearing team there. Stop them before they can set up a drill.
I can do that.
Good. And according to the security reports, there's a Thanator and her cub there. She's protecting her territory.
And her young. They're very dangerous, but I'll try and keep them safe.
Oh!
stop the RDA here. But they killed the Thanatos. The mother and the cub.
It's all just so pointless. So cruel. I wish I could stop them.
You are stopping them. We are stopping them. Together. Now I'm going to make sure they can't use this equipment again. Priya, I'm done here. How's the testing going?
The oil toxicology is about as bad as expected. I'm still waiting for the full underground imaging. The payload went deep, deeper than this oil seam. There's something really fishy about it.
If you work it out, let me know.
I hope you're not tired yet. There's movement at a fissure in the Kinglor Forest. It looks like they've deployed mapping probes. They're looking for something underground. It's cool tech, but really toxic. Takes up a lot of pollution.
I'll disable them.
Good. But before you do, send me the data they found. The RDA are up to something. And I need all the info I can get to work it out.
Whoa!
Okay, so the RDA are using radar probes to collect a mad stack of resource data, and they're beaming it someplace else. Try and access the probes, so we can just yoink the data and shut them down. What they can't see, they can't exploit, right?
they gotta stop her.
Area.
That's one. Priya, I'm sending you the data now. There's a lot.
Got it. The RDA are mapping wide and deep like they're looking for something. But what? Shut them all down. I'll call when I've worked this out.
One more left. Priya, I've disabled the probes.
Amazing. I don't know how you do it. I'm standing here panicking at a computer, and you're taking down RDA prospecting sites like they're nothing.
Thanks. I've had a lot of practice.
Okay, I'm done here. I've got all the data I can. The survey results, itineraries, everything. It looks like all of the oil drilling operations came from the same forward base. There's a lot of equipment stored there.
Send me the coordinates.
But I need to swing by one last fissure. The RDA haven't been there yet, and I want some clean samples.
Be careful, okay?
Aren't I always? Don't answer that.
Priya?
Sorry, right. I need to patch HQ into this. One second.
Priya? Are you okay?
Kinda, no. The data I got from the drilling sites? Mercer's got a bigger plan, and we're talking less fissure and more meteor strike. Well, in terms of scale, not atmospheric phenomenon, which means...
Priya, it's okay. What have you found?
Read Meta. I'm sending the data now. I need you to run a simulation, but I think Mercer's going to pollute everything.
Can you both get back here? If you're right, I'll have to gather the clans. I'll need your voices.
I've got to get one last oil sample, then I'll be back.
And I have to take out one last RDA camp. I'll be back as quick as I can.
Come when you can.
Not good enough. Vulnerable spots. Fuel, power. There's no base without those.
Recruits are pretty dumb. They'll believe anything you tell them.
Thank you. electronic control.
I'm gonna get eyes on you.
Priya, I've taken out the site. Where are you?
Just getting the last samples, then I'll call Ankasu. Oh, yeah, this can't be good.
Is that one of ours?
Yeah, no. An RDA patrol's just flown over. It's fine. There's no way they can spot us down. Yeah, it's coming back around.
Get into cover!
They've seen us! Run!
Priya, come in! Priya! Priya? Are you okay? I was so worried.
We're okay. Well, we're cowering in a cave and those idiots haven't found us yet, but it won't take them long to figure it out. That was real smart getting us stuck in here, Priya.
Just sit tight. I'll distract them.
Thank you.
Priya, come in. Are you okay, Priya? It's safe. The RD are gone.
Am I glad to hear your voice? We're good. We're good. Heading out of the cave now.
You know, on Earth, rocks don't float. Every time I see it, it messes with my mammal brain. I'll never get used to it.
I'm not even used to Pandora yet. There is so much more to discover.
Which is why it's so important to protect her, right? The good news is, toxicity-wise, the land will heal. Which shows how totally brilliant your world is. Being an ecologist on Earth, well, ecology's pathology, as my old professor used to say.
That's so very sad.
It really is. Pandora is so alive and so beautiful. It terrifies me. But I'd do anything to protect it. I'll have to run the simulations, but I'm pretty sure Mercer's plan will destroy all of this. The clan leaders are meeting at the HQ now to figure out how we stop him. I just hope we can, you know? Head back to HQ soon. We need you there.
Whoa!
You got it! Let's go, Storm. Something. Heavy losses. Don't think so. No. No, not yet. But what else? Na'vi Hunter shows up, attacks RDA, takes down Amp Suit. Maybe it's linked to... RDA firing at wildlife. Terrible aim. Must have had interference. RDA hunting the severed. Attacked by a Na'vi hunter, skilled. Takes them down, including Amp. The severed run away. Amp was leaking oil. A scent trail.
Many parts of the forest have blossomed, and now their center is thriving.
Well met, friend.
The scent is fading. Must hurry. Concentrate, Sadne. You will not miss again.
Satne, the Sky People back there.
They were in my way. The Sky People hunt the silenced for sport, unable to tell one from the other. My target is among their prey. Years ago, a beast with no kuru mauled me to the edge of death. I have hunted it since. No one will deny me this kill.
Might be more Sky People roaming the area. I would help if you let me.
Very well. I saw some around the Dreaming Hermitage, where mountains float overhead. We will meet here when you are done. The Silenced One. An old battle-scarred beast, cut away from Ewa. It will receive a proper death, finally.
Oh!
Feral Thanator. Don't think it was here. Should find her.
My quarry. My prey. After all this, an undignified death at the hands of the Sky People. I have drawn my bow at this beast many times. My arrows do not miss unless I allow them to. And I have missed this beast many times. It feels strange to say this. It almost killed me. And yet, I saw it as a victim. Much as I was.
What changed? You were ready to kill it now.
I had to. The Sky People, with their ugly weapons and gleeful hate, forced me to take action. This beast was wounded, vicious, but I still wished to give it a fitting end. I failed. My hesitation, my refusal to do what I knew was right. There will be no more of this inaction. Anufi will need my support more than ever. It is time for me to return home. I see you, brother. Rest easy. You can stop hunting. I will carry on for both of us. May your spirit run with Ewa.
Yes. Something to help with the stubborn piece.
Sarentu, here, a moment of your time. I have lost Manwë, the occasional singer and perpetual fool. He has not been seen for quite some time.
Where did you last see him?
Here. He is a steady sight to many of us who have also left the Kamettire. Always ready to trade me those musky seeds he carries around for a tale. The last time he was here, I elected to tell a more uplifting story. When I finished, I saw there was something different in his eyes. As though he sought me out as Manwë that night, and left as another.
Must have been an invigorating story.
Even the best story is to be taken as inspiration, not as instruction, as I fear Manwë has. I have outlived my Ikran and been unable to search for the old fool. He could be anywhere.
If he took the story as instruction, then maybe I should hear it as well.
When you are ready.
Takari, if you would.
An untold age ago, an old warrior set out to walk a fabled path surrounded by mists that would only end in death. Nearing the frayed ends of his mortal thread, the old man did not fear death, but welcomed it. But death took its time, and so the old warrior pondered his path. On the highest of peculiar stone clouds was a tree draped in a reverie of crimson hues. It was the most beautiful tree the warrior had ever seen. Then he came across a weeping colossus, and befriending it, was allowed to climb atop its head and hear it whisper its sorrows. Finally, he snuck past a gargantuan that was not of this world and sought refuge behind gnarled roots. The warrior chuckled at how his hands shook. It was here at last. He stared down death in the form of a winged beast adorned in a hideous, unnatural carapace. As he fell to the beast, the warrior understood this path he walked now. He had sought out death, and death told him to choose life.
Can I ask what it all meant?
For Manwë, any story was preferable to the one we Kamettire have been shackled to. He wanders with his sad pouch of seeds. Like the warrior, he has no fear of death.
We have some hints as to what he'll be looking for in the story. That's a good start, I think.
I will await your return. And my friends.
The wood that grows there is brittle.
I wonder when our next feast will be.
What I would not give to trade with the Zeswa again. Hey there. I had a... boss. To stop the archers falling. That is what I heard. I might go gather moss tomorrow.
Get me some if you go. My sleeping area needs it.
Floating clouds, was it? These seeds. Manuel was here at some point, maybe. Weeping Colossus, I guess. And these seeds. Manuel came here. Maybe it's linked to... RDA and Not-Vi bump into each other. Not-Vi might be rusty with a bow, takes a few out. Could be Manwë. But what else? Not-Vi fled the scene, not before dropping a pouch smelling of those seeds. Manwë's favorite. Alone Not-Vi, possibly Manwë, bumps into RDA. Neither side prepared. Not-Vi takes down a few RDA, then escapes. Drops a pouch with a distinct odor. The smell. Strong enough to track. Whoever you are, hold tight.
I do not be-
Manwë? Are you hurt?
I'm fine. Just a bit of bruising here and there. The Sky People did not expect I had some fight in me. Neither did I.
Why did you come out by yourself? Takari's story?
Yes. It led me to stumble across the Sky People. And so many of them. I think old Manwë gave them a scare, eh? They even sent out one of their hideous metallic Ikran. However, I have brought them here for a reason. This area is rife with hives that will hinder them in ways arrows cannot. I will teach them a harsh lesson about this land. Ugh. After a rest, yes, just a slight rest.
Easy, Manue. You're injured and in no shape to take them on.
No, young friend, I am. I am so close to finishing this story.
Takari will have my head if she knew I let you risk your life again.
Oh, I can already see that sharp gaze in her eyes. Yes, very well. But I will fight alongside you in spirit. Consider the hive a gift from Ewa by way of me.
Last batch of arrows felt a bit heavy.
Turn, dip, spin. Turn, dip, spin.
attention. Oh, dear. You insist on wearing those ridiculous
garments. Oh, 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 oh!
I just need to talk to her. Say something clever.
The Sky People are dealt with. It's safe to go home now.
Home. It has been a lifetime. After you, your people were taken from us. I have not been back since. I came out here expecting death, but I have been a corpse wandering aimlessly for a long time.
Takari feared you took her story too literally.
Only a tale, yes, of course. I only wanted to follow this story to see if I was meant for death.
You sought out death, and you're still in one piece.
When death revealed itself to me, as those Sky People... Oh, you should have seen me. I too chose life, if only for that moment. But your flattery does not change the truth. This conclusion, this battle you won, it will be your story to tell, not mine.
Manwë came to see me again. A bit worse for wear, but ever the comforting presence as usual.
Did he, ask for another story?
He did not, and I have a feeling he will have less use of my stories now. The warrior chose life the moment he set foot on that path. Manwë has not realized this yet, but he felt it.
He's a lot more clever than he knows. There's hope for him.
Yes. He thinks this was your story to tell, not his. And he is wrong. Inside the Kamet Tire, many Manwës. They will soon learn to make their own stories again. And I look forward to telling them. Yours as well, Sarentu. Until we meet again.
What I would not give to trade with the Zeswa again.
You should try to...
My friend, fight. Who are you? Why do you bear the mark of the Sarentu?
I am Sarentu.
The stories are true then. May your appearance be an auspicious sign. I am Kelu of the Kametire, and this here is my dear friend. Though I wish you got to meet him in happier circumstances. The Sky People have corrupted his feeding grounds. It is as if he drank poison that he cannot purge. He often feeds on his favorite plant to build his strength, but I fear he does not have it in him to find it himself right now. Banquet mushroom would also help purge his blood. I could bring him both of these, but I do not dare leave his side.
I'll get you some while you look after him.
Here are tricky. Yeah, true.
Hostile.
position.
At the bridge.
Thank you.
I bet there would have been more if I'd been quieter.